Hi, Wade Kawasaki here, and welcome to this Car Guy Adventure. We are in St. Petersburg, Florida at the St. Pete Grand Prix for IndyCar. And I'll tell you, we just watched a phenomenal race here where Colton Herta led flag to flag, just did a great job, dominated the race. It was a phenomenal race to catch up with. And who I got to catch up with is my buddy and my friend, the CEO and general manager of Dallara USA. Now, Dallara in any given race weekend has 300 of your race cars racing in Formula 1, Formula 2, Formula 3, Formula E, WEC, the World Endurance Championships, and IMSA as well. So, I mean, they just got race cars in every single venue, including here with their presence with the Dallara truck and trailer at the Indianapolis, at the IndyCar race here in St. Petersburg. Stefano, thank you so much for joining us for a minute, and why don't you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Absolutely. Thank you, Wade, first of all, for your friendship and our relationship in the business. I'm Stefano dePonti, CEO and General Manager of Dallara USA, the only headquarters outside Italy. We are located in Speedway, Indiana. You say our presence basically in the racing community. We are serving and helping pretty much, you know, all over the world in different categories, in all the continents. In the US, we are so honored to participate here, to be in a partnership with IndyCar. In the Life Series, we had this great race in St. Pete, Florida, as well as we have a great important program with the Cadillac, with IMSA, with the most important races and Euro races, Daytona 24 hours, Sebring 12 hours, and so forth. What we see here on this big trailer basically is our unit, that our transporter. We go every race in the IndyCar races and Indy Light races to do technical and engineering and commercial support to our team. Being a solo supplier for the Dallara chassis to the IndyCar teams, obviously our mission is to serve in engineering way the team the best way we can.
Wow. And commercial. So can we impose on you and allow our friends to join us inside
Please,
of your truck?
I'll be on with
okay, you. That's great. Let's go.
Okay, let me explain you what's going on here. This is a racing transporter, but compare the other racing transporter. This is we carry all the parts that the team need to maintain and to repair the Dallara IndyCars. In particularly, we have more or less $2.5-3 million in value in parts. So that doesn't mean that necessarily we will sell them all, but at least we must have a really important inventory in order to supply parts to the team in case they need to. Let's remember the IndyCar team, basically they do have as per average 2 to 3 cars per driver. So those cars are continuously rotating according to the racetrack that we're going to have. For instance, next week, this trailer, we're going back to Indianapolis, do the inventory, put more parts in it, and then we will head into Texas Motor Speedway, where there will be another IndyCar race, but actually 2 IndyCar races, one on a Saturday and a Sunday on Super Speedway. So different cost configuration, different layout, and different parts. So this is very important to keep the supply chains and the parts supply for our teams, which are the best customer of us. So let me explain how works. I think we're going to start from this book, which is the official Dallara parts book, which is like a manual. The principle here is like any customer, if you think, imagine to go to Napa Auto Parts,
right, and
need a particular parts. Obviously, our parts manager and the parts guys that work for the team, they're very familiar with the parts they need. But in case, we use this manual and this parts book as a support. We have all the commercials number, all the description, the technical number reference, and of course, which is one of the most important part, the price.
In any business, that's the most important.
We do this for business. when we do that, the other mission is to pick up, according to the to the book.
Wow.
Whatever parts we need. I mean, we have a different typology here. There's machining parts in metal and composite type of fiber parts in composite. The feature and the characteristic of this part is every single part is barcoded. Every single part is barcoded. Or they have a reference commercial number. Why is that? We must be able to track down every single part in case of the part's failure.
Right.
Or liability. We need to know they're helping us in investigation when a big crash or something related to a part's failure is happening. Luckily, we don't have many of those, so that means the car is quite reliable. It's been designed and produced back in 2012, and even if every now and then, every year, we had some new parts, particular parts, however, we keep everything tracking down and monitor it. Safety is number one before anything else.
Amazing, amazing. Yes. It's like, I think you described it the best. This is like the world's coolest Napa Auto Parts store ever, right? I mean, it's like awesome.
We have obviously I don't know how many set of parts you can put together actually with the amount of spare parts we keep in this trailer, but the same on the same layout, the same principle, same different spare parts, we can offer the same service for the Indy line.
Oh, okay. And I thought it was interesting, so that you reconfigure this trailer when you go to a super speedway over a road course because the configuration of the car has changed.
Well, pretty much, yeah. We keep both the inventory here, but it depends on the back-to-back races. If we have more speedway races, obviously the inventory parts will be more to serve for super speedway. And vice versa, if we go to road courses and street courses, we will have more parts for this typology of races. Basically, the car is pretty much as a, we call it as a spine. It's pretty much the same. The major changes are the aerodynamic bits, so front and rear wings, and all the attachment for those. Nose box is the same. Attenuator is the same. There's a lot of similarity in parts, but obviously what is changed for the different configuration of the racetracks, other standard parts, they are also determined the performance and the aerodynamic.
So why don't we check out your little lounge up there? I mean, they've got a nice little lounge.
Yes.
The tie frame that we call an IndyCar is made by paint.
Little office. Is this your parts manager's office in here?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. That's nice. Little parts manager's office. That's awesome. And by the way, this has been the coolest place I've been to all week long. The weather is great.
Obviously, Dallara is as an Italian company for sure. Traditionally, we must have an espresso.
Yes.
Espresso machine.
This is my secret place at any IndyCar race. I can come to the Dallara trailer and my buddy Stefano will make me an espresso. Yeah. So that this is the best piece of equipment that Dallara has.
Yeah, we have so many friends in the paddock, and obviously the espresso machine is a big appealing.
Yeah.
For
as well as the Milano cookies.
Oh, I mean,
you gotta have the Milano cookies as well. Stefano, tell me, because we know Dallara as race car constructor, builder, also a new street car, I understand, is coming soon.
Street, and
that may come to the U.S., I hear. So that would be really cool, and I'm sure our listeners would love to learn about that. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Absolutely. Okay. The Dallara Stradale, street vehicle car, obviously it was a dream came true from Mr. Dallara.
Right.
A little bit of history. Mr. Dallara is a graduated engineer from Politecnico of Milano. He had a huge career in racing and working for the major and famous manufacturer, including Ferrari, Lamborghini, and Maserati. I know I'm sure you know very well that the Miura Lamborghini was a product designed by Mr. Dallara. Back in
you know what? I did not know that.
Yes.
So the Miura was designed by Dallara.
Yeah, by Giampaolo Dallara, Dallara.
Okay.
Back in the days, the Dallara as a company was not existing
yet. Right.
Dallara came out because Mr. Dallara is a pure passionate racing guy. And when I try hard with different companies, those companies, for a reason or another, decide not to go to racing, you say, you know what, I start my own company.
Right, and go racing.
And I design race cars.
Yeah.
So that's what he did in early 70. And by the way, next year will be we celebrate the 50 years anniversary of Dallara Automobile, founded by Mr. Dallara. And started with a small formula cars until, early 90s, it became quite knowledgeable enough to start his designing Formula One cars as well. And going back to the Stradale, basically this car has the 30 or 40 or 50 plus year of experience of technology of Dallara.
Wow.
Concentrated in that product in terms of safety, performance,
right,
warranty. Very successful in Italy. In fact, I invite you to go to visit Dallara.
Yes, I need to do that.
Whenever it's possible. And they move up to build a facility dedicated for the design and the construction of the Stradale. They sold different units, and now we're ready to introduce the Stradale here in the United States.
Wow.
For liability concern, we decided to use the Stradale for track days only.
Mm.
But I guarantee you, it's a racing car, it's a race car,
right,
that can be used for the Stradale. It will be FIA homologated,
okay,
with all
great,
the
yeah,
safety standard,
yeah,
and also with the best quality items for the performance. We are waiting to have the first two cars here in late May, early June. We are planning to do a presentation sometimes in September, October.
Oh, okay.
So I will definitely keep informed.
Yes, please do. I mean, and you heard it here. He invited me to Dallara in Italy, but also I want to come drive that Stradale.
Okay.
I'm going to hold you to that now.
No, I already located some racetrack on West Coast. One is Chamal.
Yeah.
And the Monticello on the East Coast. So we are talking with these people just to see if we can have events.
Nice. So my buddy's at Thermal. You heard it. I'll go out to LA.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll get on that racetrack with the Stradale. It's a phenomenal car. I mean, I've never actually seen one in person, but of course I've seen all the pictures and videos. And and also, Stefano, not that many people know that besides these super cool street cars, and after all, Dallara has been consultants to Alfa Romeo, Ferrari, Maserati for years and years and years. But also, you're now into defense and aerospace. That sounds pretty cool.
That's a good question. Thank you for brought it up. And we like to call ourselves as an engineering company.
Yeah.
Obviously, for many years, Dallara specialization was in automotive and racing, offering services, products, design, and support. You mentioned some of the brands we are working on. I like to add the Bugatti.
Oh, that's right.
Chiron, and Chiron is also a Dallara product. Most importantly, also now we are finding a diversification and helping in the automotive industry, in electrical cars, in autonomous cars. But you say, right, when we opened up the company in the US 10 years ago, before Dallara was working through an official distributor, initially I said, well, we need to take advantage and to offer our expertise and our technology to this country in different fields, not only limited to automotive racing. And we started a very long and difficult path along the certifications. Mm. So we became, for instance, ITAR certified, and we started to go after some business. One of our customers is Raytheon.
Oh yeah.
And unfortunately I cannot mention some other names because of confidentiality, but we are very, very involved also in aerospace. And building components for the ergonomic environment of capsules and missiles. And we are very active in that. And a big lesson we learned in last year, unfortunately, for the pandemic, Italy and as well as all the rest of the world did suffer a lot economically, for labor, for war, so for them to shut down because of the COVID. We managed to stay open because of this diversification we are able to achieve and consider it essential. So we could not actually stop our activity.
Nice.
And we stay open. We did help also the community. We were not busy to cut the composite carbon fiber material. We were cutting material for masks and gowns to give it a no cost to the local community, hospitals and so forth. And then we managed to do our work for the aerospace and defense.
Yeah.
Finally, and paradoxically and unfortunately, because out of this result, the company as a whole decided now it's time to react. And since early this year, we created this new business unit at Dallara for defense and aerospace. The other two are dedicated to automotive and racing. And we hire as a consultant a friend of mine, an ex-general from the Italian Air Force.
Wow.
Which he had a diplomatic mission in the United States and went back to Italy and took two commands for the force. So he's an engineer by background and he knows exactly all the work that needs to be done for contact, company, industry. So his homework is to position in Dallara in the right spot with this industry to see what kind of service we can have and how we can have.
That, you know, that's amazing. I mean, because so Dallara truly is a technology company, yes, as well as an engineering company, and just with great creativity, you know, that comes out of racing, the competition of racing and doing it better and being lighter and being faster. I mean, that all really equates to what they do in business. And so that's a really fascinating thing. So thank you for sharing that with us. And on a personal note, Stefano, what do you drive?
Right now, I'm in a lease car,
okay,
but I'm waiting for a Tonale Alfa Romeo.
Oh, nice.
Coming into the United States.
Yes.
I'm still thinking to compromise with a Stelvio, which
is already on the market.
This is on 4 wheels, but I recently purchased and I will be delivering next week in a Vespa 300.
Nice.
So that will be my summer vehicle to go to work.
See, my friends are cool, and that's cool, right? That's a cool thing to drive. So hey, thank you for joining us at Car Guy Adventures, and thanks again to Stefano dePonti. He's just an amazing guy, amazing technology in what they do here at Dallara. Thank you again for spending the time with us. And hey, make sure you hit like and follow below. We'd love to have you not miss any of the exciting content coming up, including the Stradale when it comes here as the United States. Take care.
Thank you, Wade, and thank you, everyone. Bye-bye. Thank you.